So Memcache has a way of avoiding this problem. It actually has a couple ways. The first one we're going to talk about is called CAS, which basically stands for check and set. And this basically makes two different, it adds two commands to the protocol. One is called gets, and this takes a key. And this is instead of get. And what this returns is the value plus what they call a unique, which is basically, it's basically like a hash of the value or a counter. It's some value that's unique specific to this value in Memcache. And there's another command called CAS, which takes a key, a value, just like set would, and also a unique. And basically, the way this function works is, for the key that you're setting, if the unique matches the unique that came out of Memcached, overwrite it with the value and return basically true. But if you don't pass in a unique, or the key isn't in the cache, or the unique has changed, don't set it and return false. So basically what this allows you to do is it gives you these two commands that prevent you from two people overwriting the same key in the cache. So if we have two app servers, so if they both run this memcache.gets on a particular key at the same time, you know, they'll get two return values. They'll get the value, I'm going to call that V, and the unique, we'll call that U. And if one of these app servers updates key by calling CAS, he wants to update key to the variable stored in Y using the unique U, this will succeed. It'll return true. And if this guy tries to do the same thing, Memcache will only accept one write at a time. It does it very, very fast, but only do one write at a time. So if this guy tries to run the exact same code, mc.cas, we're going to set key to a variable stored in y, passing in u, this one will return false because this app server got there first. And the unique value stored in Memcache changed. You know, what both these app servers would really do is the code would look something like this. You know, r equals, and then like, while r equals false, then you have like u v equals mc.gets, r equals mc.cas, k, y, u. So you have this loop where you basically, you know, get the new unique out of the memcached and then try to set it. And then once you're setting the unique that you got out of memcached, or that is, the unique that's stored in Memcache now matches the one that you got out, you know that you made the correct edit. Now, generally, you only use this when you're doing kind of a destructive operation to the cache, like you're updating a list. You know, if you're just overwriting something, you don't need to worry about it. But if you're kind of manipulating an object and the order of manipulation matters, you can use something like CAS. And so what I'd like you to do is go ahead and implement these functions in our fake Memcached.